Hi guys, in this video, I'm going to explain how we can get HTML code of any website using a Python. To run a Python program, I'm using a Jupyter Notebook. The Jupyter Notebook is available in Anaconda software or you can install from the Chrome. In the description, I am providing the links of Anaconda software and the Jupyter Notebook. By going through the links, you can download the Jupyter Notebook and you can start to code and you can start coding in the Jupyter Notebook. The Jupyter Notebook environment looks in such a manner, and in the Jupyter Notebook we can create the Python notebook by clicking the new button which is available in the right corner. So you can create a Python file by clicking the Python 3 which is available in new. Okay, I have already created a Python file with the name of HTML of any website. I am opening the notebook. So this is the notebook which I have created. Now how we can get the HTML code of any website using Python? So to get the HTML code, we need to learn two modules. Now I'm introducing the modules. The first module is a request module. So the request module sends all kind of HTTP requests. How we can install the request module? By running a command pip install requests. And what does HTTP mean? HTTP is nothing but it enables the communication between the clients and servers. And this module contains mainly two methods. The first method is a get method, which is nothing but it requests the data from the server. And the second method is a post method. It submits the data to be processed on the server side. So these are the two methods which are frequently used in the request library. And the second module is nothing but a beautiful soup 4 module. So we can install the beautiful soup 4 module by running a command pip install beautiful soup 4. By running this command, it automatically install all the required packages for this beautiful soup 4. And here we need to install a parser. The parser is maybe a HTML parser or a XML parser or maybe another parser. To install a parser, pip install and the parser name. So in this task, I'm installing the HTML parser. So pip install HTML parser. So what's the use of beautiful soup 4 module? By using a beautiful soup 4 module, we can get the data which is available in the website. It's nothing but web scraping, or we can extract the data from the web page. For example, a website contains the details of 1000 members and we can't access the data of 1000 members. By using the beautiful soup 4 module, we can access the data of the 1000 members and we can download it into the CSV file, which is stored in the CSV file. And we can download the data which we require. It's nothing but we can download the data, only the address of those 1000 members, only the date of birth of those 1000 members. So in a particular manner, we can download. And coming to the logic. So this is the logic. Initially, we need to import the request module into the code. And we need to import the beautiful soup module which is available in a BS4 package. Now I'm extracting the HTML code of the Google page. So the URL is nothing but a google.com. Now I am requesting the URL. I am requesting the website or a web page. So the request.getURL. So here I am using a get method. So this method returns the response object. So here the response object is nothing but a page. So the response object contains the content and the encoding of a web page and the status code and the response headers and many things which are related to the website. It's nothing but by using this response object, I can access the content of the page, or I can access the status word, or I can access the encoding of a web page, or I can access the response headers which are available in the page. Now I am converting the into HTML parser using a beautiful soap method. So this method contains two parameters. The first parameter is nothing but the content which we want to access, and the second one is nothing but the parser. Here I am using a HTML parser. So how I can print the HTML code by using a prettify method? I can print the HTML code. Just run the cell, we can get the HTML code of the Google web page or a website. So this is the HTML code. Now as I said that the response object contains the encoding of a web page and the status code. So let us check what is the status code and the encoding. So the status code of the web page is 200. Then what is the encoding? So nothing but page dot encoding. So this is the encoding of the web page in such a way where we can extract the HTML code of any website using these two modules, the request module and the beautiful soup module. Thank you guys.